Many people in Europe associate Mitsubishi with either cheap small cars or robust SUVs. We're taking one of its crossover models out for a spin. The Outlander, explains our car man Sascha, is one of the most popular SUVs in the world. In Germany, it's still just a niche product, but the 2017 edition could change that. In Europe, the Outlander comes with a choice of two engines, a 2.2-liter diesel and a 2-liter gasoline unit. Both are available with optional all-wheel drive. Sascha is driving the diesel version with all-wheel drive. His first impression is that while this vehicle will get you through thick and thin, it won't do it very quickly. It's slowed down by its weight, and the top equipment line with all-wheel drive some 117 kilos more than the entry version with front-wheel drive. The diesel edition needs 11.6 seconds to make the dash to 100 kilometers an hour. Top speed with a 6-speed automatic transmission is just less than an overwhelming 190 kilometers per hour. Our test car is fitted with adaptive all-wheel drive. In eco mode, the one axle is deployed almost exclusively. This does theoretically allow you to meet the manufacturer's official fuel economy rating of 5.8 liters per 100 kilometers. All-wheel drive only kicks in when the wheels start to slip. The most outstanding change for Sascha, the one that no longer stands out, is that the rear antenna has been replaced by this little shark fin. The car is now a bit more streamlined. One change Sascha would like to make, and it's the same with most car makers, is the unbearably slow opening trunk lid. In winter, you really wish it would open a bit faster, but once you've folded down all five rear seats, you have a flat cargo platform and a total volume of 1,613 liters, and that's nothing to sneeze at. The third row of seats is only available with the diesel edition. Gasoline engine buyers will have to make do with five seats. Sascha appreciates the legroom in the back, but not the headroom. Even with his short hair, he's touching the roof lining. And he's worried about getting it dirty because he has a bit of gel in his hair. Sascha would have preferred this little bulge here further forward so that he would sit more comfortably. That bulge and the restricted headroom are due to the glass sunroof. The cabin is nice and spacious and uncluttered. There are new piano black accents, although your fingerprints show up everywhere. The cup holder is now hidden away under a special cover. But the most important new feature in the Outlander has to be the safety package, available for an extra 1,400 euros. It includes a blind spot alert that also warns the driver of rear cross traffic when leaving a parking space. It's especially useful in the city, not least because of all those cyclists racing around. Insulated windows help to keep out noise. The diesel engine does get a bit loud, says Sascha. That's primarily due to the automatic transmission, which is pretty harmonious, but sometimes isn't sure what to do, so the engine revs higher than necessary. At the same time, it costs 2,000 euros extra and comes without an automatic start-stop, something that Sascha can't quite comprehend. All in all, the Mitsubishi Outlander is a solid enough vehicle. Having all-wheel drive available is a big benefit in the winter or in the mountains. Plus, you have a lot of space for the whole family and cargo. Its real strength is its price advantage over German car makers, even if the workmanship loses a couple of points here and there. But that's it.